now we're going to talk about other vaccines that really are a must-have for a pregnant woman before, during, and after giving birth. Dr. Sirven, we have some here that I'd like to discuss with you, if you can walk us through this.
Well, definitely the ideal time to get vaccinated is before you get pregnant. Mm-hmm. And the vaccines that are mentioned here, the measles, the mumps, the rubella, which is the MMR vaccine, is important to be given prior to pregnancy or after delivery for those patients who don't have immunity to it, because those are live vaccines and they are contraindicated during pregnancy. As described here, the Tdap vaccine should be given during the pregnancy, especially in the third trimester, because all the studies have shown that the majority of the immunoglobulins that are found in the baby's blood after delivery is those that are received in the third trimester of pregnancy. And then the flu vaccine should be given the flu season in every pregnancy.
Because as you noted, it's from, you said, October all the way to May. That's a long period of time.
It is, but that's when flu season happens.
Doctor, which vaccines should the babies get after they're born? Lots of mothers are always wondering, does my baby need this? Is it necessary? What do you recommend?
Well, the first vaccines the baby receives after they're born is the hepatitis B immunoglobulin vaccine. And there's a lot of pros and cons in which people describe whether autism is associated with vaccines or not. No studies have shown that this disease is associated with the vaccination of the children. And I think developing hepatitis is a lot more dangerous than the risk that you take with the vaccine.
Some parents still sometimes insist, doctor, and I'm sure you get a lot of these patients where they say, you know, I'm just not for it. I don't want these vaccines. What are they looking at if they don't do it?
Well, I think that you increase the risk of your baby developing this thing. I defer a lot to the pediatricians in this topic because I think it's ideal for them to communicate with a pediatrician and discuss all those concerns because of their knowledge is definitely more advanced than what we have as an obstetrician. But my recommendation is to receive these vaccines because there hasn't been any studies that associates the treatment of any vaccines with a disease cause.